been sick for the past week and it's so annoying. I literally didn't feel like doing anything as far as like going out. First of all, because I didn't want to get anybody sick. Let me sit up. By the way, the reason I'm not sitting on the couches is because I'm more comfortable down here and I have something like my ottoman is holding my camera, so with my tripod, so that is why I'm on the floor. Anyways, today I wanted to talk to you guys about my experience as far as making friends in the military with other spouses, and also giving you guys a few tips based on my experience. So without further ado, let's get started. If you guys have been following my vlogs since day one, you guys kind of have an idea of how long I've been living here in Fort Bragg. For those of you that don't know and are new to my channel, welcome. I moved here around October of last year, 2017, and when I first got here, I was lonely. I remember it was my birthday, and you know, Fort Bragg is not that far from Charlotte, but I wasn't able to go on that day to Charlotte and hang out with my friends, so I pretty much just stayed here. I remember feeling just so like upset because I just hadn't met anybody as far as friends. I know that's something that can be really common as a military spouse, especially because you move with your husband or wife somewhere and you just don't know anybody around the area. It's a new place, it's a new environment, and sometimes some of us are really shy and not really outgoing, but it is important to make friends, because if you don't make friends, one, you don't have a support system, two, it can get really, really lonely, especially when your spouse goes out to training, which they do most of the time. Having friends is definitely a must, in my opinion. It was a week after my son turned one. That's when I met my first friend, and to be honest, I just like asked her something about her son, and we just hit it off from then. What I do recommend is definitely like trying to get out of your comfort zone and speak to somebody. I became friends with her, and then she introduced me to a Facebook group. Now, before I met her, I don't think I was in any Facebook groups because I didn't know that was a thing. And so she invited me to a Facebook group, and after that we went to some party and I mingled there and just met some more spouses, and just, you know, that's how I made friends. And I was really grateful that she helped me in that aspect too, because I was able to meet a lot of people through her. And shout out to my friend Karina. Going to wherever you're stationed, they have Facebook groups and you can join. I do have to say that there will be drama depending on who you become friends with, and if you do not want to deal with drama, I definitely recommend for you to just say bye bye. Like, I'm not dealing with this, I don't have time for this, because there are military spouses out there that their lives are just full of drama, and then they just like to involve you, or they're just jealous and just mean and stuff like that. So yeah, you will get your average bullies out there that are out there, but like I said, luckily I haven't came across that, because one, I don't pay attention to it. Two, I don't pay attention to it. So basically just one. This might be TMI, but it is very common in the military to come across spouses that are couples that are swingers. So yeah, that is really common in the military. So if you are new, or new military spouse and just moving into a military base, and you start like hearing about these things, don't freak out. It's common. I don't practice that, no. But it's really common, and it's just their lifestyle. And to be honest, like, I don't judge. That's their business. So another advice would be, just don't really get yourself involved in somebody else's business. Because then that just creates drama as well too. I did want to also warn you guys that another type of female or spouse that you will come across with is the party type, the one that's always partying when their husband is gone. You should definitely keep in mind that if something is affecting your relationship, that just stay away from it. But yeah, so to be honest, making friends at first can be hard, but once you meet the right person, it opens more doors. Don't get discouraged. I hope this was helpful in some ways. If you guys would like to see more videos of Josie's World, feel free to subscribe down below this video. I don't know where the subscribe button is, but it's somewhere down there. Stay tuned for more videos. Bye.